Goldenrod is a perennial plant that is well known for its healing properties. It reproduces through its roots, bulbs, stems, and by its seed, and does not actually cause seasonal allergies as many tend to believe. No one can be, allergic to this pollen. Why? For starters, goldenrod produces virtually no pollen. It is actually pollinated by insects. Only wind-pollinated plants such as ragweed, which blooms at the same time as goldenrod, can cause allergic reactions. Currently, there are actually 140 varieties of goldenrod, therefore it has a unique adeptness in crossbreeding with other plants. All varieties are equally nutritious and boast many health benefits. It can be used fresh or as a dried herb to make tea, although it is bitter, or as a fluid extract, tincture, or in capsules. Nebraska declared a type of goldenrod, Soldiago gigantea, as the state flower in 1895. Distinguishing features: long wood-like stems with spiky tooth-like parts which are widely spaced, and yellow flowers that grow in thick clusters. Flowers: goldenrod flowers grow as an inflorescence in a broad or occasionally narrow pyramidal panicle. They can be anywhere from 5 to 40 centimeters, 2 to 16 inch, high and nearly as wide. There are several to many horizontal branches, the upper sides of which carry numerous, densely crowded small heads of golden yellow flowers. Each individual flower head measures about 3 millimeters, 1/8 long and wide. This plant flowers from mid-July to September. Leaves: there can be wide variations in characteristics, but generally, goldenrod leaves are about 10 centimeters long and 2 centimeters wide, tapering to a point at the tip and narrowing at the base, with no leaf stem and small teeth around the edges. Three veins run parallel from near the base of the leaf. The underside of the leaf is hairy, especially along the veins, and the upper side has a rough texture. Height: most plants average 1 meter in height. Habitat: there is no shortage of goldenrod in September and October. This yellow plant can be found in moist locations, forests, fields, roadsides, compost piles, cultivated fields, and orchards throughout Canada, the US, and across the world. Edible parts: all aerial parts of the plant can be used. The flowers are edible and make attractive garnishes on salads. Flowers and leaves, fresh or dried, are used to make tea. Leaves can be cooked like spinach or added to soups, stews, or casseroles, and can also be blanched and frozen for later use in soups, stews, or stir-fry throughout the winter or spring. Other name: Canadian goldenrod. Recipes: goldenrod oil, goldenrod vinegar, and minty goldenrod tea.